we ask the gardeners to come back up, we're going to pick up a love offering tonight. Amen.
Thanks for God when I'm misery. Bigger than a highest mountain, taller than trees, stronger than a locomotive, faster than a bullet speed. He's wiser than a man named Webster, eternal and deity. Nothing to be forgotten, really.
Song, isn't it? The words won't let me play it any better. Oh, Lordy, okay. We'll try. Amen. Michael's going to pull a song up off a track that's probably close to 30 years old. And you can tell it when you hear the track. But it's a song that I wrote after one day somebody come on my front porch. I let them in. They had what I thought was a Bible in their hand, told me they wanted to talk to me about God and about the Bible. I began to talk. And we began to talk, and I thought, man, this stuff she's saying doesn't sound like my Bible, so let me go get my Bible. And we began to talk, and she told me that she wasn't going to go to heaven. She was going to stay real meek, stay right here and inherit the earth. You ever had those conversations?
Yeah.
And I'd never heard of that before. I was young. And, you know, I thought, well, that's interesting. But then what really rubbed me the wrong way is she told me, furthermore, she didn't think I was going. And the best I could hope for was to stay right here on this earth. Well, if this earth is all we've got to hope for, then, yes, that's right.
Come on.
And so I wrote this little song, and it says what I'm about to say.
Come on.
Gonna be long gone when that last trumpet sounds. I'm gonna be long gone. My feet are gonna leave the ground, and I've got no plans to stay down here. One of these days I'm gonna disappear, leaving in style in a short while. I'm gonna be long gone. I know you've heard the story told, how the clouds of glory will unfold like a thief. In the night he'll take his church out of sight. No tribulation will be spared, great tribulation everywhere. But you won't find me there, I'm gonna be long gone. I'm gonna be long gone when that last trumpet sounds. I'm gonna be long gone. My feet are gonna leave the ground, and I've got no plans to stay down here. One of these days I'm gonna disappear, leaving in style in a short while. I'm gonna be long gone. Amen. What about you? Yeah. You can stay right here if you want to, but I'm going. Ain't no one preached to the world it's gonna rain. They laughed and said he's gone insane. But when God shut the door, they weren't laughing anymore. You know the rain started pouring down, but the ark was sailing safe and sound. When the water covered the ground, no one was long gone. I'm gonna be long gone. Oh, when that last trumpet sounds, I'm gonna be long gone. My feet are gonna leave the ground, and I've got no plans to stay down here. One of these days I'm gonna disappear, leaving in style in a short while. I'm gonna be long gone. Long gone.
When that last trumpet sounds, I'm gonna be long gone. My feet are gonna leave the ground. And I've got no plans to stay down here. One of these days I'm gonna disappear. Leaving in style here, so I'm gonna be long gone. Well, I've got no plans to stay down here. One of these days I'm gonna disappear. Leaving in style here, so I'm gonna be long gone.
Old Jasmine sang this while she got good breath in her.
Come on.
I've got hopes, I've got strength, I've got everything I need. Only hope is provided. I've got joy, I've got peace, I've got happiness. Waiting deep inside.
Yeah.
I've got a lot to thank the
Lord for. Every day is blessing more and more. Food on my table. Shoes on my feet, I'm telling you the Lord makes my life complete.
He heals me when I
don't feel well, saving my soul from hell.
I'm gonna
ask for more, I've got a lot of faith the Lord for.
I've got family, I've got friends, I've got a nice place to live. How could I complain? I've got more than enough.
More and more. Food on my table, shoes on my feet. I'm telling you, the Lord makes my life complete.
He knows me when I
don't feel well, saving my soul from hell.
How could I
ask for more? I've got a lot to thank the Lord for.
John at the hour of prayer.
Not yet.
Peter and John at the hour of prayer. Blessed Lord. Begging there. That silver and gold they had none to share. Oh, but so much, so much more.
Well, hey, pour this one out. Regina, you sang this.
I wrote it, I should know it.
Yeah. Try it again. Everybody say it with me.
Blessed Lord. Peter and John at the hour of prayer. Peter and John at the hour of prayer. Then my man begging there. Get silver and gold, they had none to share. Oh, but so much.
Two or three are
gathered. I'm singing the wrong verse. Can it be? Your burdens will be lifted, as in His name we agree.
There's no other name like the name of Jesus.
No other has the power to save or to heal.
Each time I call his name, his presence I can feel. There's no other name like Jesus.
Y'all ought to know this second verse now. I'm singing twice down here.
Peter and John, at the hour of prayer, they met a lame man a-begging there. Yet silver and gold, they had none to share. Oh, but so much more they gave the man, as Peter reached down and took his hand. The name of Jesus, but to the temple he ran.
No other has the power to save or to heal. Anytime I call his name, his presence I can feel. There's no other name like Jesus. No other name whereby we must be saved. No other name to take to a watery grave. There's no other name. No other name.
There is no other name like Jesus. Sin from above.
Ooh, ain't going down one now. Ooh. Oh. Tenor part, I was about 50 pounds ago when I.
Bless them, Lord.
How many remembers the Hensons?
Yes.
Oh. Yes. You sure you do, Brother George? You that old?
I'm pretty old, brother.
Yeah. I want to do one now.
I remember the original Hensons.
That song we done a while ago, Long Gone, was produced by Ronnie Henson.
Yep.
And that song is fast. And I remember sitting in the studio, and he looked up there, pushed that little talk button, and he said, put an edge on that. And I thought, what does that mean? And the guy was keeping the timing with the metronome, the drummer, and he click, 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 and Ronnie said, edge it up a little bit more. And he said, now, Mitchell, see if you can sing with that. Man, is that ever more fast? Was that? That makes you feel like talking in tongues, I know. I'm not sure why I told you all that. Go.
This won't sound nothing like Kenny. This won't sound nothing like Kenny Hinton, but it's a good song that he wrote.
Sorry about that.
You can always find a steeple, a few religious people.
Come on.
Well, there's a preacher on the front steps shaking everybody's hand. A sign shaped like a Bible, saying summer revival. Well, there's a million dead churches filling up a neighboring land.
What we need is a soul. A filling station,
yeah.
Full service, open 24 hours a day.
Just love that
high octane, super salvation.
We're
a heart out of gas, feel it for that fast getaway.
You remember that song, Brother George?
Yeah.
I bet you sang it, Hank.
A time or two. Been a while.
A great choir.
Come on.
Dressed in long white robe attire.
Yeah.
or a wall full of trophies showing off your softball team.
But if the people aren't for praying,
the people aren't for praying, then that's how many that stay in.
Cause ain't no one going up on the watered down gasoline. What we need is a toll, oh yeah, a filling station. That's what we need. A full service open 24 hours a day.
Yeah.
We're pumping the high octane, a super salvation.
Yeah.
Heart and a gas can fill up all that fast-fueling. What we need is a soul at the filling station.
Yes, we do.
A full service open 24 hours a day.
We're pumping that
high octane, a super salvation.
We're a
heart out of gas and feel it for that basket away.
Yes, we're a
heart out of gas and feel it for that basket away.
Well, I'm in a hurry to get away.
I told you I wouldn't sound nothing like genius.
Oh, I found that track I was looking for.
I told you, man. Everybody say it. Blessed be Jesus.
Yes, I'm on the battlefield. Oh, my Lord. Yeah, I'm on the battlefield. For my Lord. Oh, I promised Jesus that night I went to the altar, I'd serve him till the day that I die. Now I'm 35, almost 40 years later, still on the battlefield for my Lord.
Oh, I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. Yes, I'm on the battlefield for my Lord.
I like this old song. I promised
him
that I would serve him till I die.
Oh yes, I'm on the battlefield for my Lord.
Yes.
Woo! Holy Ghost, get on the Lord.
Yes, I'm on the battlefield for my Lord.
Oh, yes, I'm
on the battlefield for my Lord.
Oh, yes, I'm on the battlefield for my Lord.
Lord, I promise you, I promise him that
battle for my Lord.
battlefield.
On that battlefield. On the battlefield.
Oh, my Lord. For my Lord,
yes, I'm on the battlefield.
For my Lord, oh, yes, I
promised him that I
would serve him till I died. Oh, yes, I'm
on the battlefield.
For my Lord, oh, yes, I promised him that I would serve him till I die. Now I'm
on the battlefield.
Yes, I'm
on that battlefield.
Yes, I'm
on that battlefield. For my Lord.
Well, that's kind of how the track I thought was supposed to go. Them tracks are always wrong. I guess y'all can tell we never practice.
Amen. Very
good.
Bless you, Jesus.
Well, praise the Lord. The Bible says that a merry heart doeth good like a medicine.
Yeah.
I guarantee you, people out in the clubs tonight, even the bands that's playing, they don't play perfect.
No, they don't.
They make mistakes. I'm going to tell you, I've been in front of hundreds of people and act just the same way when I make a mistake. Because if they come for perfection,
come on, bro.
they came for the wrong reason.
That's right.
Yeah. I mean, we're here to worship God. And nobody's ever going to get up and ever make a mistake. We went to the quartet convention and sang on little things here and there with people in so-called professional groups.
You ought to hear, buddy. I've been there.
It's made me sick. Ooh, is that too... I'm feeling too much at home tonight.
But George, you gonna post that on YouTube?
It's out there, brother.
It was good. Not always, but many times... It was so non-spiritual that all it was good.
Mm-hmm.
I can buy good on DVD.
Mm-hmm.
When I come to church, I'm looking for more than just good. I want it. We should give the Lord our best.
Our best.
Come on. And we should strive for excellence. I want to sing on pitch. I know I don't all the time. I hit it sometimes. Sometimes not. But if I don't... Whatever. If somebody's blessed, we need to, let me back to my thought. Merry heart doeth good like a medicine. And we need to take more medicine. Amen. The joy of the Lord is our strength. Michael's got something he's wanting to do over there.
Well, he's my favorite singer, so I'm going to ask him to sing another song here.
Amen. Mm.
Yeah. See, they're listening to you very hard. Now, I want to do this song written by our good friend. He's gone on to be with Jesus. Carol Magruder. I know you've all heard of the Magruders. He wrote many, many good songs. But this was a song that, I don't think this never made the charts, but we were singing with them one night at an event at a church up in Knoxville. Back before Jasmine would come on, probably when she was a little baby. Been a while ago. But he sang this song that night, and I remembered it. The last time we did a recording in Nashville, which has been a long time, we were looking for songs and things, and I remembered that song, and we recorded his song, and here it is. God is too, it's too good to be true. That's the name of it.
Come Richard on. Does
good. It fits him, it's kind of country-fied.
Yeah.
It's too good to be true, but it is.
Come out.
Ever since he found me, I've just begun to live. My life has new meaning since I learned to forgive.
Never thought I'd find a deal like this.
It's too good to be true, but it is.
Sometimes I have to pinch myself to prove it's not a dream. Sure feels like the real McCoy, not just some worthless scheme. This way of life I'm living, it beats all I've ever seen. My friends all think I bet the farm on this.
It's too good to be true, but it is.
Yes, it's too good to be true, but it is.
Ever since he found me, I've just begun to live. My life has new meaning since I learned to he forgive.
I never thought I'd find a deal like this.
It's too good to be true, but it is.
I like this verse. Can never remember it, but I like it.
I came to him with nothing. That's all I had to bring. He didn't try to bargain. He had offered everything. Life made me a pauper. Oh, but God made me a king. I never thought I'd find a deal like this. Yeah, it's too good to be true. But it is.
It's too good to be true. But it is. Ever since he found me, I've just begun to live. My life has been me since I learned to heap of you.
I never thought I'd lose my voice like this.
It's too good to be true, but it is.
What a blessing.
Oh, my life has been me since I learned to heap of you. I never thought I'd find a deal like this.
Thank you, Brother Dan.
It's too good to be true, but it is.
Big ending.
Yes, it's too good to be true, but it is.
Mitchell a break since he's my favorite singer. I want to do a song that I sing by myself. We've never tried it. Jasmine can jump in there with me. She can sing with anybody on me. And I need the help, baby. But this song is kind of, I'd heard it, and it just fit me to a T and all of us. And you'll understand why when I start singing it. This is a great song written by Michael Combs. You got Michael Combs drinking from the saucer?
Yeah.
This is not it. One Blessed Man's name is this.
Well, I have a house to keep me warm, to shelter me from the storms. Yes, I am one blessed man. And I have a wife who holds me tight, and she prays for me each night. I am one blessed man. And these are a few of the blessings that I have known. If I had the time, I could go on and on. I have children and grandkids, and I don't know what I ever did to be what I am. One blessed man. And And I have Jesus in my heart, and I know that He won't depart, for I am one blessed man. These are a few of the blessings that I have known. If I had the time, I could go on and on. Now if someone says to you, who's that man and what does he do? Just tell them I am one blessed man, for that's who I am. I'm one blessed man.
Great message to me.
Called him the act of old adultery. The law said she must die. Death by stoning was her penalty. She wanted the her penalty, but they wanted the Lord to reply. While they stood with stones in their hands, Jesus wrote in the sand, said, if you are without sin, go ahead, begin. They could not cast the first stone. He had a right to cast a stone. He never sinned or done wrong. He was the only one that day that was perfect in every way. But he did not cast a stone. Walked in the back door, sat on the back pew, desperately needing a friend. Could this be the moment? Could this be the hour? Her guilt and her shame finally ends. Would the people just turn and stare at her, knowing the things she'd done wrong? Or would they find forgiveness in their hearts for her? Or would they only cast stones? He had a right to cast a stone. He never sinned or done wrong. He was the only one that day that was perfect in every way. Cast a stone. Oh.
that is without sin among us, let him cast the first stone.
Amen. Glory to God.
We could just stand together across this house. And I don't know, Pastor, if we just come to stand right up here. He touched me. Maybe you need a touch from the Lord. Oh, he touched me. Why don't everybody just join us right here? And oh, the joy that floods my soul. Something happened, and now I know Jesus touched me and made me whole. I was shackled by a heavy old burden. I was beneath the load of guilt and shame, but then the hand of Jesus touched me, and now I am no longer the same.
Me. Oh, he touched me.
Yes, he did, Lord.
And oh, the joy that floods my soul. Something wonderful happened.
Galilee has walked up and down the aisles of this church house tonight. I believe that.
Yes.
And I know we live in a time and an age and world where Hollywood and maybe even the elites in politics thinks that what we're doing right here is just silly and crazy. Maybe you saw it, but CNN. Some religious leaders met with our president, and there was a picture that was taken of evangelistic leaders laying their hands on the president.
Yes.
Did anybody see that?
I saw it.
And I was so proud of
yes,
that.
Yes, I was touched.
You know, Donald Trump, what you may or may not think about him, you know, he didn't have to allow them to do that. But he did. And the CNN commentator didn't realize what they were doing and really criticized it and said it was strange. But you know something? When we as a church begin to be so commonplace that the newcomer walks in our doors and they never ask, man, what was that? And if they never say, that was just a little strange.
Oh,
the book of Acts, church, on the day of Pentecost, they said, what meaneth this? I was glad that they said, what does this mean? And the world may not understand it, but we know and we understand that strangeness that they don't understand is what brings deliverance, what brings hope, what brings happiness. And in this house right now, it is here. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Pastor, God bless you.
Here you go, buddy.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Do you hunger and thirst for him? Amen.